Hi, my name is Zoran Horvat. Today we are continuing our discussion about how to write code that contains no bugs. This episode is a continuation of the series where we have started from a procedural implementation of the quicksort algorithm. This is that implementation. It was quite verbose. It had a lot of details where the bugs could hide. We have then proceeded to formally proving that this code effectively does not contain any bugs. And then we have moved our attention to adding debug assertions in places where we would entail the proof. We would demonstrate in debug build that the state of the program is as expected in critical points. Today you will learn a different coding style, which is not so imperative, not so procedural like this one, which will dismiss bugs. The idea is to write code which looks the same as those assertions we made to demonstrate that the state of the program is correct. I will start a new class for the new implementation of the quicksort algorithm, here it is. And you will quickly see what I mean when we start implementing this function. The first step will be the same as before. Actual sorting function will sort the span, not the list. But now begins the difference. This is the place where we started that cryptic solution before. We'll do it totally different this time. We would assert that a span with one or less elements is sorted. Then we remember the quicksort algorithm. It is a recursive algorithm which splits or partitions the data into left and right partition, and then applies recursively to the left and to the right partition. Now, how do we implement that so that the code reads the same as these comments? So that we don't have to write assertions, that is the point. Well, let's solve the first case with the guard clause. Then, partition a span, return two spans out. We cannot return spans like a tuple because span is a ref struct and it cannot be a member of the tuple. The more important detail is what is this partition method? It still doesn't exist. We will write it. Don't care about that now. Care about the rest, sorting the left and sorting the right recursively. This is the quicksort algorithm implementation. Is there anything to prove here? Is there any bug here? Can there be a bug here? No, because the code is reading exactly the same as the specification of the algorithm, so only if the specification of the algorithm is wrong, this code will have a bug. Now we do everything we must to make this code compile. Here, that is that partition method that was missing over there. And so we remember the partitioning algorithm. One step is to move the pivot to the first position in the span. Then we separate the gap elements around the pivot. And in the last step, we move the pivot to the middle. And it demarcates the split between the left and the right partition. That is the partitioning algorithm of the quicksort implementation we are producing here. And again, we write the code which reads exactly the same as those comments as the specification of the algorithm. We don't have to think about neither this method or that method we completed over there anymore. Both methods are complete. They are final at this state. And we don't have to think about them anymore. We only think about the methods they are calling for lower level services. We will now implement these functions. And if you like this video, this is the moment when you can really like it. Press the like button, thank you. That will help me spread the word about my channel. We will declare the three functions used from the partition function. So these are the next three functions we must implement. We can implement each of these in isolation. They are independent. They do not depend on each other. They don't depend on anything else. Make functions self-sufficient. let everything they depend on be passed to them through their arguments, and let everything they have to say just a return value. Then you will be able to focus on that single service, that single method you're implementing, and make sure that that method does not contain any bugs. Then everything else, supposedly being right, will make a whole which contains no bugs at all. For example, this last function is very easy. Make sure that you have a long descriptive name of the method which tells very precisely what it does. And when it says it that way, just implement the body the same as what the method is named. And what could go wrong there? You see, there is no room left for making bugs in a code like this. Moving the pivot, select the pivot index first. We must select one element from the span as the pivot, so let's give that to a different method. Let's not write that code here, because I'm really afraid of making bugs. I want to split the operation into smaller ones, like here. Select the pivot. I don't care how, just give me the pivot index. Swap the pivot to the beginning. Everything beyond that point remains as the gap. It's done. Let's move to the next function. How do we select the pivot index? We had that helper algorithm, which we used to select the pivot, like choosing any three elements of the span, like the first, the last, and one in the middle, and then taking the middle out of the three using the sorting criterion. Look, the method is done again. I'm just picking the middle out of the three. I don't know how that is done. This index of middle, that is somebody else's problem. Speaking of bugs, of potential bugs in this method, I don't think there is any room to make them here. The method is complete again. Index of middle is so general that it doesn't even belong to the quicksort algorithm. We can define another class and put that operation over there. That brings us back to the final method which we are missing, the one that is partitioning the span around the known pivot value. I will put the old procedural implementation here so that you can see what we are fighting with. This is the code we must make more expressive, and we must make it safe from bugs. That will be the real problem. Let me just run the application so that we can see where we are right now. The first output is for the new algorithm, and the second output for the old algorithm. Both are sorting the test data correctly. But if you look at the code we made so far, look at the quicksort method. This is the quicksort. And the other function, this is partitioning. Well, that is the style I wanted to show you in this demonstration. Self-documenting code so that if you wonder whether there is a bug here, you just read the code, compare it to the requirements, and you say, no, there is no bug here. Those two things are the same. But now we are looking at a real problem. How do we apply that coding style, that self-documenting coding, to this function? This function is really complicated. That will be the last step in this series, and we will do that in the next video. We will introduce self-documenting types. Types that have the meaning which is equivalent to this code. And everything this code is doing will become members of that type, that expressive self-documenting type. I hope you liked this video and that you will join me in the next episode where we will complete this demo code and you will see it will work fine. And we will also do our best to keep performance degradation in check. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.